Hello students, today we'll discuss competitive programming 1, a compulsory module for third year student in computer science and engineering under DBOTU Lonery. Before discussing about the content of the subject, let's discuss about course outcome of this subject. So what course outcome it consists is that when we complete our subject, what student will gain or what student will achieve from this subject. That is nothing but a course outcome. So this course outcome consists CO1 to CO6, which are representing unit 1 to unit 6 of this subject respectively. So let's discuss the first CO. At the end of successful completion of course, student will able to understand basic programming challenges, language and feedback from online judge. Here student will face number of programming problems and they have to use different languages such as C, C++, Java to solve that problem and submit on given platform or given site where they will get the feedback on their submission. Next, CO2. Student will able to understand and apply the concept is the data structure. Here different kinds of data structure concept has to understand by the student, learn the different concept used in the data structure and use to apply that concept on a given problem. Next, CO3. Student will able to understand and apply the concept used in data, used in string. So there are different kinds of methods which are used to represent the string. One should understand about that concept and apply on the problem set. Next, CO4. Student will able to use a variety of string technique to solve the problems. Here, string technique in the sense of the concatenation of the string, finding the length of the string, sliding of the string, or such kind of operations or such kind of techniques, string technique, the student has to learn and use them while solving the problem. Next, CO5. Make use of arithmetic and algebraic method to implement in given problem. There are numerous arithmetic operations and algebraic operations are represented in the book. Then student has to understand this concept and use them in a given problem. CO6, student will able to understand the counting technique and use to solve the given problems. So this has consist the course outcome of the subject, where at the end of this subject or end of this course, student will gain this concept or this knowledge representing from CO1 to CO6. So let's start with the first unit of the subject is introduction. Getting started with the judge. First year, we need to understand what online judge is representing in this subject. The judge are nothing but one kind of website where you are submitting your problem statement, and depending on your submission, they will give you the certain kinds of feedback which will understand or which has to clarify by the student depending on the feedback. So what is the problem statement provided with the good introduction to the demanding nature of robot judge. I need to read carefully and understand specification. Here, whatever the problems has been specified, the student has to read it carefully and understand what specification is required or what solution is required to represent the problem statement. To deal with this, we are having a two website which representing the online judge. So the first one is programmingchallenge.com and another one is onlinejudge.uva.es, where these two sites are used to submit their problem statement. And on this site you will find hundreds of problems are available on it, where the interface of these two websites are different, where these two judges are describe different representation with different interface in between them. So basically the interface is consists of password governing access to your personal data, especially your name and your email address. Here it means while you are accessing these two websites, you have to provide with the authentication. That means you should log in to the sites and you are able to submit your solution for the given problem statement. So first we'll discuss about the first website, that is programmingchallenge.com. It provides a special feature associated with each of the problem statements. So what it consists, what this site is representing, is basically the web interface for submission instead of email interface of the UA judge. Here the interface is just only the login credentials, not required for the email interface to submit the solution for the given problem. Why this is? Because the submission which make easier and more reliable and provides the quick response for the student submission. Next is programming challenge site has social course management interface, where the instructor can maintain the student roster so that he can see the submission of the students and what output or what result the students are getting. Depending on that, the instructor can simplify whether the student has submitted its own work or not. Next is the University D-Validate Robot Judge. This is another website. The second website is onlinejudge.uva.es, where the large number of problem statements are collected in this site. Here you require the registration for this website, and which basically represent by the email containing an ID number which uniquely identify your program to the judge. Here the interface is basically representing with your email address, and along with that it will provide the ID number for every solution you have or you may have to submit with the ID numbers. The feedback from the judge. Here it comes. Once any website you are going to use, if you submitting the solution for a given problem, the feedback we are getting from that site. So what kind of feedback we are getting from the site? We'll call this as a judge. So feedback from the judge is likely to return one of the following verdict. The first feedback is getting here is accepted, the abbreviated as AC. It is important because while you are submitting the problem statement, you might going to be see such kind of feedback, so one should understand about what this feedback is representing. So accepted, it means the program is successfully submitted, and which is correct one, and run within the given time and memory limit. So whatever the problem statement you have submitted is in within the time limit or within the memory limit, because of that it has been accepted. Next feedback we are getting is presentation error, abbreviated as PE. So basically this feedback we are getting because of the presentation is not in a specified format. Your answer is correct, that means your program output has been correct, but the presentation we have made is not up to the mark. And what we need to find out within the presentation is to check the spaces, left and right justification, or some kind of line feeds. Such kind of presentation you have to check it and resubmit the output of the program. Next is accepted PE, abbreviated as PE. So what it consists, or what this feedback is, your program has a minor presentation error, but the judge is letting you off with a warning. That means your program is correct, program output is correct, the presentation has some minor representation within it, but still it has been accepted with the warning, because there are a number of ways to represent about the output. So it may be having ambiguous output specification, so it has been accepted. Next is wrong answer, abbreviated as WA. This is why should concern you, means here you need to seriously take concern about this feedback, because your program returned an incorrect answer to one or more of the judge cigarette test. Here it means there having the different kinds of testing has been done or a submission by the online judge, and in any of this test, if it is get failed, the feedback will come as wrong answer. You have some more debugging to do it, so you need to go for one more debugging or number of debugging to find out your feedback of to find out your errors within the program. Compiler error. The compiler error not figure out how to compile your program. The resulting compiler message will be returned to you. Warning message that do not interface with the compilation are ignored by the judge. Here basically the problem has been occurred because of different languages we have used. Suppose the one of the site is has familiar with or support with C++, and you have done the program in Java and submitted on that site, so it might find a compiler error. Runtime error, is RE. Your program failed during the execution due to the segmentation fault, floating point exception, or similar problem, this dying message will be sent back to you. Check for invalid pointer references or division by zero. So most of the problem has been occurred because of this. It's some kind of punctuations are missing, some kind of syntax which are not represented, or sometimes the calculation which has been done by dividing it's zero, or maybe having a pointer reference to the given variable is not correct. So because of that, we are getting this runtime error. Time limit exceed, that is TL. This basically this error is occur, or the this feedback is occur because of the problem with the efficiency, where the runoff your problems or your solution has run out of the time on one input does not mean you correct on the other, all others, however. So this feedback is getting because of your program is taking too much time to execute the program. Memory limit exceeds. This also basically representing the program type to use more memory than the just default setting. The specific memory has been provided for the given problem statement. So if it is exceeding that memory, then we'll get the memory limit exceeded. Output limit exceed, OL, that is abbreviation. Your program tries to print too much output. This usually means it's trapped into infinite loop. Infinite loop in the sense of your program is, the code is repeatedly executing the same block of code. Because of this, we are getting this kind of feedback from the site. The restricted functions, REF, is abbreviated. Your source program tried to use an illegal system function such as fork or open. These are the errors, or these are the feedback we are getting while you are submitting your problem set. Submission error. Yes, see, it's the last feedback we are getting from the judge. You did not correctly specify one or more of the information field, perhaps giving an incorrect user ID or problem number. This is basically feedback is occur because you are not correctly mention your ID number, or you might have not filled the correct information within the field. Because of that, you are getting this feedback from the online judge. Thank you.